it appears that these animals are communicating with clicks, and we're just starting to understand what those may be. And the key to understanding the click communication between these animals is to first understand their echolocation. Now, dolphins and whales view the world through clicks, through a form of sonar. What they do is they send out a very loud signal, and they wait for the echo of that signal to come back. And they collect all of that beneath their jaws, and they process that to see with sound better than you and I can see with our eyes. A dolphin can tell the difference between a ping pong ball and a golf ball from 300 feet away by clicking with sounds. And a sperm whale can see a human from a mile away, a mile deep can see a human. These are the loudest animal sounds on the planet, sperm whale clicks are. And they can actually penetrate through flesh, so they can get a 3D view of what you look like. Now, we've known about cetacean echolocation for 50, 60 years. But what we've learned more recently is they use these clicks in social behavior. And these clicks are extremely detailed. A sperm whale can repeat the same click over and over again, down to the millisecond, and then can move around discrete frequencies within that millisecond-long click, move them around and reorganize them and repeat those over and over again. This is more precise than anything humans can make, okay? It's not a dog barking. This is obviously some form of communication, and we're just sort of getting a view into what that might be. The problem is that a lot of people view cetacean communication as some new age theory. This can't possibly be true. These animals can't possibly be speaking in a sophisticated language like ours. But just take into consideration the sperm whale brain. It is 6 times the size of ours. Sperm whales have a neocortex, which in humans governs higher level functions such as conscious thought, future planning, and language. Their neocortex is about 6 times the size of ours. They also have spindle cells. These are highly developed brain structures that neurologists have associated with feelings of compassion, love, suffering, intuition, and guess what? Speech. So these are the cells that are supposed to make humans human, separate us from other animals. Sperm whales not only have spindle cells, but they've had them for 15 million years longer than we have. So what are they doing with them? Animals don't grow big, complex brains for no reason. They obviously are growing them for something. And just for instance, humans have we've had our current size brain for around 200,000 years. It's a pretty long time, right? They've had theirs for about 30 or 40 million years. So they're leaps and bounds ahead of us.